Well, as we bring this to a close, probably just your final words, Mary and Francisca. Let me start with you, Francisca. Mm-hmm. Anything you'd like to share with the public today concerning the conversation that we've just had?
Well, I would like to say that it's important to share. Mm-hmm. Just share. Mm-hmm. There's nothing new on the face of this earth, and there is someone out there willing to listen. Yeah. So reach out.
Reach out. Yes. Mary?
I'd just like to tell people that it's okay not to be okay. Mm-hmm. That's what I'll say. It's okay not to be okay. Mm-hmm. So don't feel like you're the only one going through an issue. There are people like you. All of us have gone through an issue and we've been able to come out of it. So you can always feel encouraged, mm-hmm. and go out there and look for help. Mm-hmm. Talk. So
talk.
Let's talk.
To someone. Share, talk. Mm-hmm. Rose?
What I can just say is to, I would tell people out there, there is hope.
There is hope.
Despite of what you've gone through or what you're going through, there is hope. You are never alone. Mm-hmm. Know that God is there. He promises never to leave us, and he walks with us. So it's very important, always rely, put your hopes on God. Have faith and walk with the word of God. Mm-hmm. He'll never leave you.
He'll never leave you. Well,
yes.
Said. Thank you so much for creating time to come and talk to me about managing stress and depression. And thank you for watching. Thank you for your loyalty. Wherever you're watching this, I know there could be that one thing that you're going through and you're feeling like life is just not worth it. Remember that you have no right over your life. If you feel like you have nothing to live for, God has not decided that it's the end of things for you. So you have no right over your life, and you have no right to take that life away. And at the end of the day, if something is huge, so strong and so complicated for you, remember, God cannot give you a challenge that you cannot go through, something that he does not give you the grace to go through. I feel like preaching, but I have to bring this conversation to a close.
Yes.
And keep it KBC Channel 1. There's more coming your way. Matters Politics Crosstalk is about to hit your screen, something you don't want to miss. But first up, People Like Us is up next.
Gone are the days when retirement was dreaded and referred to as the slow puncture towards the grave. It is probably the most exciting and enterprising time of anyone's life, as long as you choose to approach it with optimism.
My name is Winson Wekesa, a resident of Sirungai village in Divisi location, Webuye East sub-county, Bungoma County.
Councillor Wekesa takes us through his daily routine, which clearly portrays a hard-working person who loves peace and always focused to his work.
I've been a civic leader for 20 running years, starting from 1988 up to the close of 007.
He is a people's person who works with both the high and mighty, as well as the low in society, with respect and attention.
I've worked with several other political leaders, including the likes of Muskari Kombo, Mukhisa Kitui, the late Vice President Wamalwa, former MP John Barasa Munyasia, and many others. I also worked within the category of civic leaders in the County Council of Bungoma at that time, including the current MP for Kabuchai, James Mukwe Lusweti.
Winston's exemplary performance as a leader endeared him to the people who continue to trust him with their personal problems. As a clan leader, he spends a good amount of his time offering good counsel and support across the board.
I developed and made a lot of friends. I also, I think, created a bit of confidence to most of the people I serve. So whenever they have issues and problems, they'll always come around to seek my advice, to seek my assistance where need be, and that's how I live with them. We keep sharing majorly morning hours, very early hours. Those who have issues come visit me. We take tea together. We discuss whatever there is. Thereafter, they part. They leave me do my jobs.
Kwa majina mimi naitwa Eric Namsasi Jared. Ni former councillor, Jetambe stroke Lugusi ward. So ni mzee mwenye ako na heshima. Ndio naona hata nikitaka kitu hata in fact like in my family. Most advice napata kutoka kwake. Na amenisaidia kwa mengi sana. Hata kuelimisha watoto.
Yeah, I'm Dorothy Wambasi from Divisi. I've known Mr. Winston Nagtare since 2010. He's a good man. He's a caring father. Since I came to this home, he's been concerned about the life of us and generally the community. He loves it. We say in our language, we normally say, you can only feel angry when you are not reached home.
He is passionate about his people's culture to the extent that now laments the erosion of culture at the altar of modernization.
Our youth who stay in town and or who have been exposed to external world tend to think that their culture is primitive and that the Western behavior is the best. So It becomes a point of detraction of the youth taking up the culture seriously. Two, because of high level of intermixture of the communities, say, quote Nairobi as an example, we do not have specific areas where we can observe our cultural rights. Like it is easy to identify them when it comes to the ground in the local communities. So that when we look at Nairobi as such, we have a high level of mixture of almost every Kenyan. And because of wanting to look uniform, there is a tendency of deviating from cultural rights.
Shida yao, ile freedom yenye wanapewa na wazazi. Tu, like today being a Sunday, wanaona mama na papa wameenda kanisani na watoto wamekaa nyuma. So it's like watu wakubwa, mama ama papa, wakienda kanisani ama vijana wakubwa wakienda kanisani, wanahakikisha pia wameenda na youth. Because kwa church, huwa wanaelimisha watoto, vile wanaweza kukaa kwa njia nzuri, wakuwe na tabia nzuri. Lakini sasa wewe ukienda kwa kanisa na mnawaacha watoto nyuma, mnataka walisaidiwe namna gani? Na pia kwa kanisa tuko na mafunzo.
Kukaa nyumbani, baba ndiye ananiambia na ninaelewa, fanya hivi mam, na mimi nafuata tu ile baba ananiambia. Tangu nikuja hapa, hata si kujua nalima vizuri lakini vinaniingia hapa. Sasa baba akanionyesha kazi ya jembe hivi kupalilia.
When you spend time around Councillor Wekesa, you quickly appreciate the fact that though some leaders are made, true leaders are born. His charm cuts across all ages and his mastery of the social, political and cultural issues is amazing. He switches from one discipline to the other with so much ease that you are left wondering which facet of life will be his real pet subject.
My experience in politics has shown me a lot of loops in Kenyan political history. People keep changing hands, not specifically because some leaders are incompetent, but because they don't test well with a few of the elites in the Kenyan state system.
Mtu mzuri sana, tunampenda na mwombea maisha marefu ili aendelee kunipatia mwelekeo katika maisha yetu.
Right. Good morning, Kenya. The only way to start your day. And here is Crosstalk. There is a statement that was made by Eliud Wabukala, the former Archbishop. He said that corruption in Kenya should be declared a national disaster. And on that note, we begin our interview this morning. I have two gentlemen with me that I would have introduced themselves. Gentlemen who are here to talk about the issue of corruption, to share their insights, views, ideas, and channel everything towards the center. And what's the center? Solutions. Here we are on Crosstalk. My name is Victor Muyakane. Good morning. And with me is Mr. Calvin's Award.
Yes.
How are you, sir?
I'm very fine.
You're doing well?
I'm doing well.
All right. Yes. And Mr. Makowiti?
Yes, good morning.
Karibu sana.
Asante.
Tell us about what you do, sir. What do you do in the effort towards nation building?
I'm a member of the Constructive Engagement Initiative. Mm-hmm. And on a daily basis, or very constantly, engage Kenyans on good leadership, good practices that at least help us have a better tomorrow.
All right.
Yeah, having agreed and also acknowledged that we are in this country very temporarily, but we are handing it over to another generation.
Right.
So how are we? What are we handing over?
Interesting question.
Yeah.
What about you, sir? What do you do with yourself?
Yes, on a daily basis, I'm more of a development expert.
Mm-hmm.
I'm always engaged in educating, creating awareness on the issues of good governance,
mm-hmm,
and good leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Because actually we cannot talk about good governance because corruption is an effect of that, which includes both the system and the people managing the system or those who want to manage the system. And there's the participation of the people. So I'm more engaged in trying to make the people aware on how best to engage with the governance,
okay,
to achieve the best outcomes.
Fantastic.
Yes.
Gentlemen, would you agree with Archbishop Wabukala that corruption is indeed a national disaster, or should be declared a national disaster, Mr. Wolf?
I think, yeah, corruption should actually be declared a national disaster.
Mm-hmm.
Up to where we have reached, the levels are so alarming that if we continue the way it is for the next 2 or 3 years, then we will not have a country.
Mm.
Yeah.
Actually, there is a report, a recent report by PricewaterhouseCoopers that says that in 1 year alone, the rate of economic crimes rose by 17%. This is the same report that actually placed Kenya as number 3 in the list of the most corrupt nations and all that. 17% in 1 year, the rate of economic crimes. Again, would you agree that it's a national disaster? And would you agree with him that in the near future we will not have a country, as he puts it?
Yeah, actually, as much as it's very much in order to declare it a national disaster, there are some other factors we have to consider and understand, because declaring something a national disaster does not really provide a solution.
Mm-hmm.
It might only create a lot of debate and discussions around the whole issue.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of it, if you look at our history as Kenya, we tend to discuss things a lot. We enjoy that. But when it comes, it's just like the proverbial story of the rats, where they decided, this cat has been eating our people. We need to decide. Tie a bell around the cat's neck. So any time he comes, we can hear the bell.
Mm-hmm.
People agreed it's a good idea. But now who ties the bell? No one wanted to do so.
Mm-hmm.
Fearing that maybe when I'm going to tie, he might wake up and I'll be gone.
Okay.
Now, we need simply to also understand what exactly gives rise to corruption. As we declare it a national disaster, we need to understand the factors that feeds into it.
That feeds into it. And yes, we'll get into that in
Let
a
me
moment.
Just add on to that.
Yes, please.
The reason why corruption, and the Archbishop wisely said that it should be declared a national disaster, means that it would grab everybody's attention.